Okay, so the question is now, you have to split the string, with the space, but do not use split function. Split the string, but don't use split function. This is the logic. Just splitting without using split function. Let me execute this and see whether it's coming or not. Just wait, let it get initiated. So that's a U bond that's coming. 6 is a U bond. So 6 U bond means how many values? 7 values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 values. Let's see whether it's coming or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7. Got? Okay. Let's understand the logic that what I have written. Let me rewrite from the beginning again. Okay. So instead of this. First, I have a string. Right? So I have a string. Now, next, what I'm doing is dim all values. I'm declaring a dynamic array. Why I'm declaring a dynamic array? Because I don't know how many values are going to come next. Right? Okay. Next, I'm using index, one additional variable called int index. Default value I'm setting with the 0 because array value will be starting with the 0. So the initial value I'm starting with 0 here. Okay. Next. I'm resizing the array. Initially, you know, I will be resizing to index. So the initial index number of the array will be set to 0. Okay, so that's a starting index. Next, what I'm doing is I'll say int total chars of len of the str. I'm getting the length of the string to get one by one character. I loop from first character to last character now for I equal to 1 to int total characters str character equal to mid of str comma I comma 1 str comma I comma 1. Now what I'm doing here, I'm getting one by one character. See what I do now, if str char is not equal to space, if it is not space, sorry, not equal to space, all values of int index, initially it is 0 for now, first time, equal to all values of int index, that means current value of that index number, ampersand the character what you are getting. So you are appending the character to the same index. That is when it is not space. But when it is space, instead of appending it, what I do is I'll say int index equal to int index plus 1. So whenever the space has come, you increase the index number, but you have to resize the array to set the next index, right? I'm using redim and preserve. What is the preserve here? So the previous values and the per previous index numbers, if the values are assigned, you keep them. Otherwise, if you don't use preserve, as soon as it redefines, the previous values, whatever assigned for that array, will be eliminated. That's the reason I'm using preserve here. You know about the preserve. All vals of int index. What I did? I just use next. Sorry, it should be end if. Sorry, it should not be next. Done with the logic. Message box. I'll say uBound of all vals, and let me run this. Sorry. Getting? Okay, let's understand how this logic works exactly. First, you know this, right? I'm just declaring a dynamic array here. Then int index, keep the default value as 0. Now you say redeem all vals of int index, nothing but redeem all vals of 0. All vals of 0. Right? Why I'm setting this? Because initially array number should be starting with 0, array index will be starting with 0. Then I'm getting all the length of the string, nothing but count of all the characters. Why I'm getting this? Because I want to loop from first character to last character. And then I'm doing that, first character to last. Assume that there are some 40 characters, then you say int total equal to 40. So 1 to 40. Then it will be, it will give one by one character here. First time it will be T. Now, so execute this. I is 1 initially. So that str char will be T. Now you check this condition. If str char is not equal to empty, is it empty? It's not empty. It is T. Sorry, not equal to space. So is it space? No. So it is T. So since okay, this condition is matching, this condition is matching, it comes inside here now. All vals of what is int index right now? 0. All vals of 0 equal to all vals of 0 plus ampersand str char. Nothing but empty ampersand t. So all vals of 0 is equal to t now. So t is coming. Next, go back. I will be 2 so that it will get h. So again, this condition only matching. So it say all vals of 0 equal to all vals of 0, nothing but t ampersand h. It will become th. Go back again. I value will be 3 so that it will bring I here. So is again this condition is will be matching. Now again you say all vals of int index, nothing but int index is still 0, equal to all vals of int index, nothing but th right now, all vals of 0, ampersand str char is I, so that it will become thi. Go back again. I value will be 4. So str char is nothing but s. Again, this condition will be matching because still it is not space. Then you say all vals of 0 equal to all vals of 0 ampersand str char. Str char is nothing but s. Okay. Go back again. Str char is I is nothing but 5, so that it will bring space. So whenever the space is there, instead of coming here, it comes here this time. Now int index equal to int index plus 1. What is int index here? 0. So it will be 0 plus 1. So int index will become as 1. Next you say redeem preserve all vals of int index. What is int index now? 1. So it will be set to my all vals of 1. But if I don't use preserve, whatever is I have set it to 0 now, that value will be gone. Right? So if I want to retain the value which I assigned to 0, then I have to use preserve the, right? I have to use, this is the use of the preserve keyword, right? Okay, now. So it will be set to 1 now index. Go back. I value will be 6, so that it will bring I here. So it is not space, so that this condition will be matching. Now when it comes here, what is int index now? 1, not 0. So now 0 has got this. Now the next characters will be appended to 1 now. So all values of 1 equal to all values of 1. Right now it is empty, so no character is assigned to that yet. So empty ampersand str char, then it will become as I. Again go back, it will I become 7 now, so it will bring S. Again this condition is not matching, so, sorry, is matching. So all values of 1 equal to all values of 1 ampersand str char, nothing but what is there in all values of 1 now, I is there, I ampersand S, it will become as IS. Then again it goes to 8, it brings the space, then comes back again. You say int index equal to int index plus 1. What is there in int index now? 1 is there. It says 1 ampersand, sorry, 1 plus 1. It will become 2. Int index will become 2. So then it say redeem preserve of all values of 2. So the index number has been changed. So 0 got this and this has got is. Right, so index 1 has got is. Now again the next characters will be appended to index number 2 till the space has come. Whenever the space is coming, then a new index number will be created, remaining characters of the space after space appended to that particular index. That's it. So split without using split function.